Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So this is the video for your phase 1 exams of RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any banking exam at the level of PU. So let's begin this video. But the students who are coming for the first time, do subscribe this channel and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we resolve queries of students. So this is the basically a doubt resolving platform that we have created for our students. So the link of this is in description below. If you want to resolve your queries or you want to have free quizzes, you can join that Telegram group. Here is our first question. Which of the following organization has launched the scheme for approval of hygiene rating audit agencies? So first of all, this scheme. For approval of audit agencies, hygiene rating audit agencies. The scheme has been launched by Quality Council of India. Now, what is the purpose of this scheme? The name itself is suggesting scheme for approval of hygiene rating agencies in India. So, the basic purpose of this scheme is to increase the number of hygiene rating agencies in India. And these hygiene rating agencies provide the assessment, or basically they assesses the businesses on the basis of their hygiene practices. So the purpose of launching this scheme is very simple, that is to create awareness among the consumers about hygiene maintained by different food businesses, and to give consumers a choice to compare among the businesses which one is doing better in terms of maintaining hygiene protocols in line with the FSSAI's protocols or instructions. Now, this scheme has been launched under the FSSAI's, or basically not under, in line with the FSSAI's food hygiene rating scheme. So under this scheme, the hygiene ratings are given to businesses in the form of star or smileys, and under, in line with this scheme for approval of hygiene rating audit agencies has been launched. Now we have two organizations here. First is FSSAI, which is the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. Who is the chairman, who is the CEO of SSAI? So it is Arun Singhal. The second agency of importance here in this question is Quality Council of India. Now, who is the chairman of this council? That I'm not going to tell you. This is your question that you have to answer in the comment section below. Losar is the new year of which of the following community? So, Losar is the festival that is celebrated on the new year by one of the communities from the option. Basically, Losar is the new year of one of the community. So, which community is it? It is Buddhist. So, Tibetan Buddhists celebrate their new year in the form of Losar festival. Now guys, this Losar festival, there is an interesting fact related to Losar festival, and that is that this festival is observed in the 11th month of Tibetan calendar, but it is celebrated on different dates by different locations. For example, the people, the Tibetan Buddhists residing in India celebrate Losar on a different date, and people in Nepal or in Tibet celebrate the same festival on a different date. But the month remains the same, that is the 11th month of Tibetan calendar. That was the basic information and interesting as well that I wanted to share with you. But the thing of importance here is that Ladakh Union Territory celebrated this Losar festival recently in Leh. So that is the important thing here. Do remember this thing, that Tibetan Buddhists celebrate Losar, or Losar is the New Year festival of the Tibetan Buddhist. Next question is, with which organization has Center for Ganga River Basin Management and Studies signed an MOU for development of sludge management framework in India? So the purpose of this MOU is to develop the sludge management framework in India. Now, with which organization this MOU has been signed? It is option D, Norwegian Institute of Bioeconomy Research. So, this Center for Ganga River Basin and Basin Management and Studies, I have some interesting facts related to this center that I want to share with you guys. So, recently, the fifth edition of India Water Impact Summit was held. And this fifth India Water Impact Summit was organized by National Mission for Clean Ganga. And this Center for Ganga River Basin Management and Studies, which is short formed as C-Ganga. Now, the interesting fact related to the C-Ganga is that it is a think tank of NMCG. So, do remember this thing, that the C-Ganga is the think tank of NMCG and it is located at IIT Kanpur. And these two organizations have organized this fifth edition of India Water Impact Summit, and the theme of this summit is Earth Ganga. So this Earth Ganga is to generate sustainable economy through Ganga. So these are some of the facts related to this question that I wanted to share with you guys. Now, we have discussed, we have come across a very important agency, that is National Mission for Clean Ganga. So who is the director of this National Mission for Clean Ganga? This is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section below. With which bank has National Center for Performing Arts partnered to launch scholarship program in Hindustani music? So we have been given five options: HSBC India, Citi India, Deutsche Bank, Barclays Bank, DBS Bank. First of all, regarding these five options, I would like to tell you this thing, that all these are foreign banks that are operating in India at present. That was a basic commonality among the five options. Now, what is the right answer? The right answer is Citi India. So this Citi India is the Indian branch of Citi Group, which is an investment banking company. Now, this Citi India is located in Mumbai. Now, where is the global headquarters of Citigroup? It is in New York, US. Citi India. So, we are talking about Citi India. We should also know this thing, that the global CEO and the Indian CEO of this Citi India, Citigroup, are different. So, who is the person that is the CEO of this Citi India? It is Ashu Kohler. Now, who is the person who is the global CEO of this Citi Group? This question I am leaving on to you, because I would like to hear it from you guys. So, do a little bit hard work and find the answer of this question and tell me in the comment section below. Apart from this, you have to also find out the tagline of the Citi Bank, Citi Group. Which institute has organized the Vigyan Yatra promotional activity of the 6th India International Science Festival? So this 6th India International Science Festival will be organized virtually due to the COVID-19 pandemic. And this Vigyan Yatra is basically a promotional event. Now, which of the institute among the options has organized it? It is option A, Indian Association of the Cultivation of Science. So this is located in Kolkata. And it has organized this Vigyan Yatra, which will be run across 30 locations. So at 30 locations across the country, this Vigyan Yatra will be organized basically. So that's all for this thing. This India International Science Festival is soon going to be happened on December 22 to 25. So whatever the updates regarding this festival be there, I will update you on this Morning Tale series only. Who among the following has topped the Forbes list of the world's 100 highest paid celebrities 2020? So, the person who has topped this list is Kylie Jenner. So, she is a model, a businesswoman, and a media personality. So, more prominently, she is the media personality, and she has topped this list. Now, in this picture, all the top five rankers are there. So, Kylie Jenner, her income or her earnings, they are this much. Then we have Kanye West, who is a rapper. His earnings are this much. Earnings are not very important for you to remember. Just remember the ranks. So, Kylie Jenner at first, Kanye West at second, who is the rapper. Then we have three important sports personalities out here. Roger Federer, tennis player, Cristiano Ronaldo, footballer, Lionel Messi, footballer. So these are the five top five rankers of this 100 top 100 highest paid celebrities list of Forbes. Apart from this, is there any Indian on this list? Yes, it is Akshay Kumar. At 52nd rank. So AK is on the 52nd rank and he is the only Indian on this list. Our last question is, which company has won the prestigious Golden Peacock Environment Management Award 2020 in the steel sector? So first of all, this award is given by Institute of Directors. In order to encourage the corporates or the companies to do good in the field of environment protection. So basically this award is given to recognize the companies for their efforts towards protecting or conserving the environment. And this year this award has been given to Steel Authority of India Limited. So SAIL has been awarded with this Golden Peacock Environment Management Award, which is the second award in line for this SAIL. Basically, SAIL has been receiving this award for two consecutive years. Now, my question for you is the chairperson of this company. So, this is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section below. And here, this session ends. I hope that you have really enjoyed it. And if you have, then do like it and share it with your friends to spread the knowledge. Thank you so much for watching the video.